fresh off the boat, a Chinese-style afternoon tea. Where you get
a cup of tea or coffee, a yellow wine ice cream, and various Chinese desserts, fruits, and nuts, all served on a boat sailing through one of Shanghai's famous water towns. It's a relaxing way to spend the May Day.
Served from a Chinese wine jar is a latte flavored with yellow wine. While back on land, there are some people dressed in traditional costumes. It might be relaxing for the patrons, but underneath, it's a modern commercial real estate development in a fiercely competitive market. The project has been open for a year and was top of Dianping's search rankings during this year's Spring Festival.
新开业项目它其实有个红利期，但是过了这个红利期之后，人是不是愿意再回来？近期的六个月来访的这些，它的频次是超过了五次的。The
boats aren't the only big difference between this development and regular shopping mall. You won't find big name luxury brands or discount racks here either, because China's offline retail environment has changed.
I'm from Aberdeen in Scotland. It's great, actually. Not what I expected at all. Oh, this is unique. This is the first time I've seen anything like this. It's good. It's more of a whole experience, isn't it? It's outdoors and it's landscape and obviously built to look authentic. It's really good. It's very cultural, isn't it?
I think there's a lot of effort to create, to make the shopping experience more than just shopping, you know. The whole family's day out with food and entertainment. And this is a great place showing off this aspect.
How do you think about Chinese shopping centers currently compared with the rest of the world?
Are much more exciting.
And to keep things exciting, project managers need to be a lot more flexible.
我们以前可能在做商业的规划的时候, 提前三年或者五年来规划一个地方，但现在你看到其实 包括一些技术的发展，包括我们在做的一些模式，可能半年就有个颠覆式的变化。To
a large extent, it's unique. The market here is such competitive.
The retail property market in China has had very tough 2 years. Shopping malls and restaurants open and close frequently. The popularity of online shopping has forced brick and mortar retailers to innovate.
Unfortunately, I do most of my shop online.
China is home to more than 1 billion internet users. They brought the online retail sales to another high last year, 15.4 trillion yuan. China's had the online retail sales crowned for 11 years in a row.
Shoppers are no longer just satisfied with shelves stocked with goods. They want activities and experiences. That has become a new area of competition.
First, dining. Take a look at that one-year-old project in Shanghai. Cafes, restaurants, or beverage shops are everywhere.
2023 is the historical new high of new registration of F&B business in China. And we also see a lot of fundraising, I mean, from a private equity investment perspective, investing into the F&B sector.
Real estate service provider CBRE's first quarter report shows that in Shanghai, food and beverage still remains the main driver in the retail property market, taking up 46% of the market demand.
单纯开店的话，我们这家店其实已经回收了。这家店我们现在是盈利了。
Chen started his wine shop business 3 years ago, introducing a yellow wine beverage brand from the Zhejiang city of Shaoxing to Shanghai. His new shop at that commercial property in a water town can bring in up to 150,000 yuan a month.
我们的客单价以往在绍兴可能一开始做饮品店可能客单价二三十二三十，但是我们在上海做饮礼品店的时候，我们客单价可以到150,180,甚至200。我们的客人有时候是300、400、1000。我们也有遇过一组客人，他就是直接购买了3000块。
But not all dining or beverage business owners hit on a market sweet spot.
Usually we are talking about a restaurant's life cycle. It's about 2 years. then we need to create some kind of new brand or new concept according to the refreshed consumer demand. So that creates such a phenomenon that you see active store closure of the F&B sector, but that will be replaced with new concept of F&B stores.
90% 的客户都还是运营得非常不错在这里，然后有一些我们是在调整的.
To keep a restaurant open in such a competitive market doesn't just depend on the owner. How the shopping center operates also has a big role to play.
我们在类别上面不会让他们重复竞争，所以你看到一种类别的餐饮的租户可能只有一个，更打开一点，就不会说限制于一定是谁在谁旁边。我们会更希望他们做一些独特的东西。如果它是一个新品牌进来，可能我们会告诉他我们的一些分析跟研究，我们去抓的客群是谁，我们会去跟他一起共创他在这边的一些概念跟服务.
This mix and match approach has become standard in Chinese shopping centers, a far cry from how things looked 3 decades ago.
Only less than 30 years. In late 1990s, China has its first shopping mall.
The shopping mall Xie refers to included all kinds of commercial complexes to offer a wide range of stores and services.
And then we have the largest size of shopping mall inventory in the globe.
This was the first state-owned department store open on the mainland after the founding of the People's Republic of China. It's been here for 7 decades, and it took another 40 years for the mainland to get its first shopping mall. You can see here, surrounded by various malls, these were all built within just the past 3 decades, and they aren't even close to the new designs developers are building now.
And China doesn't just have so many malls because of its huge population. From 2000 to 2010, China's per capita disposable income more than tripled, and GDP more than quadrupled.
This also reflects the underpinning fundamentals during the past 25 to 30 years. We track shopping mall data in 18 major cities across China. According to our data, the supply peak of shopping malls actually happened during 2013 to 2014. When we have more than 8.3 million square meters for shopping mall being delivered onto the market per annum. While for the next 4 years, actually this number, I mean, for annual new supply of shopping malls will drop to about 5.2 million square meters.
And that's when the market entered into a new phase Xie calls a rebalancing process between demand and supply.
国内过去的20年或者是10年，它是高速发展的，所以大家对于这种变化的适应度是很高的，要求也是很高的，因为大家看得很多。但是在欧洲或者美国这些地方，它因为人的这种消费的习惯比较稳定，然后大家的这种变化其实没有那么大，可能更多的是说，它的供应量也是比较稳定的。但在国内的这个，无论是供应量的那个持续的攀高，还是消费者这种消费的要求的变化，它是迅速的。
In just the past 3 years, despite COVID's interruption to offline retail business, several new shopping malls have opened in Shanghai. Most of them feature a wide outdoor activity space and distinctive buildings. They have a name, non-standard locations. Their increasing market share is a result of the change in demands from both individual shoppers and brands. People love to walk around the city, and brands are looking for new locations for their stores. Shopping malls are still one of the major shopping venues or retail formats. The question is, which will succeed?
It's probably only 20% of the shopping malls can really do a good business. Probably another, 40 to 50 normal business. And while another 30 to 40% probably they will need to be reshuffled or being converted or renovated even for other purposes. We are already in this trend.
Competition among retail properties isn't going away, and they'll need to continuously evolve to keep up with people's pursuit of a new lifestyle.